Hey everybody, my name is Kademar. Welcome back for another video of NHL 9. We're going to continue this series, guys. On the last video, we ended up going to the playoffs. We finished up the season. We went into the playoffs. Actually, I think we just simply did the playoffs. I think that's all we did, actually. And we ended up going pretty far in the playoffs, actually. We went to the all the way to the finals of the Cup. Just to get eliminated pretty easily in five games, I believe, against I don't even remember who won the cup again. Don't even remember, guys. I've got such a short-term memory; it's unbelievable. Let's see who won the cup. St. Louis, yeah. So they won against us in five games, yeah. So they beat us in five games. And or actually six games, probably in six games. Anyways, they beat us. They won the cup. We were at this maybe two or three games of winning the cup, guys. So I'm thinking with just a little bit more better players for us and all this, we should be able to go back into the Stanley Cup playoff and this time maybe win it this time. We'll just have to see. Now I looked up at what I needed. I need three centers. I need one left winger, one right winger, and two defensemen for my NHL team. I am not going to focus on the minors. I don't care too much about that. So it seems like Forsberg is definitely going to be interested in signing with us, which I definitely want him. Now, one guy that I do want, though, is Erik Staal for sure. I definitely want this guy. He's there for 6 years. He wants a six-year contract. I am definitely going to try to get him. He wants a 6.55 to make sure that we do get him. Is he interested in us? He is, but who else tried to go for him? So other teams, it's the New York Islanders. He's much more interested in the New York Islanders than us, which means we're going to have to pay him the $1 million more. Or at least try to give him. We don't know if he's gonna sign with us, guys, but we'll have to try. We'll have to try and get him. So let's just try 7.55. See if he's gonna accept. That's our contract right here. We're gonna try to give him. Forsberg, I definitely want Forsberg in my team, guys. It would be really great for us. So yeah, let's just try to get him, I guess. Let's try to get that guy. I'm thinking. How many points does he have so far in his career? See? 900? We want to give him the 1,000 points, so... He wants 6 million for 1 year. This is going to be rough. This is going to be rough, guys. 1 year only? I guess... Yeah, this is... I'm not sure how it's going to go. Is he interested? Okay, he doesn't have anybody else that gave him we're not in competition. We don't have a competition right now against him for him. We don't have to give him more. That's what that means. So I'm probably gonna try to give him a little bit more years. So let's say 2 years. It's already at this right here. It's already there. If I give him 3 years. It's going to be right there. If I give him 4 years, it's going to be right here. 5 years for 40 years of age. And that would give him, hang on. So let me count that shit really quick, because I'm kind of confused. So that's 1 year more. That's 2 years. 2 years more. That's 3 years more, so that we're up to 4 years. Okay, so 7.75. We're gonna go for the maximum that we can give him, just to make sure that we can actually get him. We should be able to get him for 5 years, guys. I don't know if he's gonna sign or not, but it's not a guarantee. But here we go. Here's our two ones we're gonna try to sign now. For our third centerman, I am not sure if I want to go for Fedorov or not. He's 39 years of age. He's going to drop. And yeah, I'm just not sure if it would be a good choice for us or not. Comrie. I mean, there's good choices here. Look at this. Rob Niedermeyer and all. Robert Lang, oh boy. I forgot about this guy. Erik Sedin, though. Sedin. Henrik Sedin, we could get him, guys. He would be a pretty great player for us. He could be. I mean, he's got good offensive awareness. Defensive awareness is great as well. He's got a good amount of points. Yeah, he puts up good points. I'm kind of interested in having him. But Fedorov, what does Fedorov do? Because we would only have him for 1 year that I would give him a contract. He's actually pretty good. Nah, fuck it. You know what? Let's go for Fedorov. Let's try it out. Let's go all out, guys. We don't have a salary caps. So let's just go all out. 1 year, we're going to try to make sure to get him. So 5.8 for 1 year. He definitely will accept the contract. As you can see, it's almost on par. There's a bare minimum of interest for us to be able to give him a contract or something. So left wing now. Let's go to left wing position. Let's see what we got. We got Shanahan, Tanguy, Eric Cole as a choice. Obviously, Shanahan, 40 years of age. Would be pretty nice for us, but I mean, it would be only there for 1 year. It's not actually enough. So this is the bar, you see? Compared to Eric Cole. Eric Cole, that's the minimum you want to get that you have in order to for a player to be interested in you. That's the bare minimum. At Shanahan's point, that's a player that we cannot get because he's not interested in us. So we do not have the right to go for Shanahan. We cannot go for him because he's not interested in us at all. So we're just going to go for Tanguy or Eric Cole. Probably the best choice would probably be him. I'm pretty sure it would be Eric Tanguy. Potential is pretty much the same. So we're just going to have to see who. So 91, 85. I'm looking at the awarenesses. He's pretty good. He's pretty good in the minors as well. What about Eric Cole? Oh, he's playing. Actually plays better. He plays better, guys. Yeah, we're going to get Eric Cole. He plays better than Tanguy. So let's get Eric Cole. Now we have competition here. Two teams already want him, and this guy is not that interested in us, so we're gonna have to try and give him the maximum contract. He wants a 5-year deal. I am gonna say no to that, just because we're trying to save money here, and we're all not saving money, but we're trying to save years here. I don't know if he's gonna drop or anything, so we're gonna go up until he's 33 years of age, so we get rid of 2 years here, so we can basically go for, I guess, a 9.7.5 and 5.5, so 3.55. It should be enough. That should be good enough, I guess. We'll see if it works out. 3 years, all right, 3.55. Let's see if you're gonna sign with us, buddy. Actually, I should have asked him for a better offer than this, right? Oh, I just remember. No, we're going to give him a better thing than that. So normally it's 3 years at 3.55, but since he's not going to be interested in us, we're going to give him the 1,000 more that he wants. So 4.35, all right? That's where, as far as we can go. Let's give him the maximum. There we go. That is, now he's probably will definitely accept with us. We gotta go for right wing position. Let's see, we got Sikora, Litinen, Garen, Zetnik, Kunabel, Stafford, Latendresse, Bertuzzi. Now Latendresse, B potential. See, these two guys, they both have B potential. What did I say last time? Eric Cole, that's the point of interest, the maximum. Let me just point that out with Stafford. I think it's too much. Yeah. So Stafford and Latendresse, we cannot go for either of them because they're not interested in us. These two guys as well, we cannot go. We could go for Zetnik, Sikora. Anybody else? I don't think so. So only Zetnik and Sikora are interested. Well, I'm going to go for Sikora in this case, right? Is he the one that's... actually, defensive awareness is pretty bad. But he plays very good during the season. What about Zetnik? Plays pretty well. I think Sikora would be a better choice. So, 32 years of age. 1 year deal only. Just to see what he can do for us. Just to see, guys. 1 year deal only. That brings up to... It brings it up to 3.5. There we go. And with that, we can actually make sure that we get him. So 4.35 that we want to get him for. And he should accept for 1 year. 4.35. It's a good contract. All right. And last but not least, defensemen. It's what we need. We're definitely gonna go for Zubov. I mean, this guy's going to be ridiculously good. Definitely want to go for him. So 38 years of age. I want him for 2 years. So if I want him for 2 years, is he interested in me though? Oh, I think he's not. Oh, I think he's not interested in me. Oh, we can't go for him then. Damn it. We can't go for Zubov. He's not interested enough in us. Mezarov as well. Bomeister, we can go for Bomeister, Borton. And I guess it's it. Boyton, Bomeister. That's about it. Damn. That's a shame. That's a shame, guys. Well, alright. Let's go to school for Bomeister for sure. Is he... Does he have... Yes, we have competition. He's not fully interested in us, so we're going to have to give him more. 3 years. I'm saying 5 years to go to 30 years of age. I'm going for 5 years, so that's 3 more years. So 3.5. Yeah, 5.5. That's the normal contract that you would be normally at. Now we can give it 1 million more. So we're gonna go for 5. We can only go maximum 5. This. So we're gonna go right there. Let's see if he accepts or not. And Boyton. Boyton is 30 years of age. Does he have somebody? We do have competition a little bit for him. So 5 years for Boyton at 35 years of age. I want to give him for 3 years instead. That's going to bring it up to 200. There we go. 2.2. And to make sure that we get him, we can actually get him for 3. I think 3 million would be enough to get him, but we're gonna try to get him. We got a lot of space, so we're gonna try to get him for sure. There we go. And this goalie wise, we don't have any goaltenders that we need. I think this is good, guys. Good enough. Let's simulate and see who's gonna sign with us. Hopefully Forsberg and Stahl, which are the biggest ones we tried for or went for, will accept. We do have a Nick Boyton, so at least there's that. Martin Gerber went with the Dallas Stars. Lettinen went with Detroit. Please, Forsberg and Stahl, accept. Let's go. Let's see who's going to accept. All right, so we got Bomeister as well. Our two defensemen, we've got them. Okay, so Eric Cole decided to go for another team instead. So we do not have Eric Cole. So that what we're gonna have to do, we're gonna have to go for left wing again and try to go for another guy. So we can't go for Shanahan. He's not interested in us. We're gonna have to try and go for Tanguy, guys. So Tanguy, we got one. So we want him for 3 years. 4 years. Let's give him 4 years to get at 33 years of age. That's will bring him up to this right here, 4.15. We could go for maximum 4.95. So that's what we're gonna do. We have competition, so we gotta make sure that we get him. 4.95. See if he accepts. Tanguy is still gonna be a good player for us. No matter what happens, it's still gonna be a good option. Eric Cole was the best of the two, but Tanguy is still good. Oh, god damn it. Okay, I've decided to reject your offer. It's quite clear how long of a contract I wanted, but you chose to offer differently. So the problem was the contract. the years. He doesn't want to be there for five other years or something in the same team. I guess you wanted a one-year contract and that's done for. We do have Eric Staal, though. And Fedorov as well. Nice. Eric Staal accepted. And Sikora decided to go for another team instead. Forsberg is still available, so we can still try him out. We just gotta give him less years. So we gotta go for another right winger instead. And we're also gonna have to try to get Forsberg to the years he wants. So he told me for the years he's got, it's not enough. So I'm gonna give him the 1 year deal he wants then. I'm gonna give him the 1 year deal for 7.95, I guess, 9.97. I could probably get him, you know what? I could probably get him for 3 years. Let's try him for 3 years. If he doesn't want to go for 3 years, if we're lucky and still there afterwards, we're gonna go for whatever, man. We're gonna go for the one he wants us, the 1 year he wants us to get give him. Sam Olsen looks like he could be the best option right here. Yeah, it looks like Sam Olsen is gonna be the best option right here. It's the only one that's actually interested in us. What does he do? He actually plays pretty good. Yes, he does play pretty good, so we're gonna have to sign this guy. All right, Samuelson. Do we have competition for him? We do a little bit, so we can give him not too much. So we can give him just like half, so 5 million more, or 5,500 more, I guess. So he's 33 years of age. I am thinking. 32 years of age, only 1 year contract, because I don't think we're gonna really be stuck with him, stick with him. So we're just gonna give him this, so it's gonna be at 7.5 or 8.5, I should say. There, is it 8.5? Is actually the hold on, okay, no, 8.5 and 6.5 because it's 2 years less. Make sure that we get him, so 5 million more, so it's going to be 2.15. All right, that's what we want. We're going to give him 2.15. Oh, we can't go further than 2.5. That's why. Okay, we're giving the 2.5 for only 1 year. That's as far as we can go, I guess. So I only want him for 1 year. See if he's going to accept or not. Hopefully they both accept. This is the only two players we got left that need to accept our offers. Shanahan went with Boston, as you can see, 3 year contract. Please accept. Okay, Samuelson went with another team. All right. Samuelson decided to go with Boston as well. All right. See, it's much more of a challenge. This is much more fun because we actually have a challenge in this one. So right wing position, see who else could be available for us. I guess Blake Como could be good. Yes, could be good. He can grow with us as well. Let's get Blake Como. Do we have anybody? No, we don't have any competition for him, so we don't have to give him more. 1 year only he wants. I actually want him for 25 years of age. Let's give him for 2 years. Let's give him for 2 years, and that would bring him up to 1.55. Just to make sure he does sign, let's give him a little bit more. So 1.95 could be good for him. I'm sure he's gonna accept at 1.95. That would be a good contract for him. See what we got? Extremely happy to accept your offer. Nice. Your cash offer was most generous. Yes, there we go. Fosberg, we got him on the team, guys, for 3 years. Now we just need to know if the Blake Como is going to accept our deal. Please accept, because we're coming down to the wire here. There we go. Blake Como decided to go with us, so he did sign with us. And we can finally go in the season itself, guys. Here we go. So everything's good. We got everything we needed. I'm so happy. We actually got three in the free agency. We actually got three studs for the center position. All right. Oh, my goodness. Look at what they want to give us. Yo, that is something. They want to give us Pavel Kubina, defenseman, 82 overall. Actually pretty decent. Yeah, he puts up good stats. Yeah, pretty decent. We've got Dwyer. So Dwyer, which is a young prospect, but he's not really going to grow, so he doesn't mean too much. But Steve Schott. They want to give me Steve Schott. Are you serious, guys? Left winger, Steve Schott, 90 overall. Yeah. 96 points in all. I am tempted to accept that, guys. For Nick Boyton, so defenseman for defenseman. They want me to give them three defensemen, though. That would be kind of a problem. Because Nick Boyton, I'm happy to give it to you. I'm sure. I mean, he doesn't predict that much great stats. Kubina would play better than him. They're basically the same overall. There we go. Trade accepted. I really wanted to have Steve Schott in my team. I mean, there was no chance of me not getting Steve Schott. It was a must. It's just a must at this point to get Steve Schott. So we got Steve Schott, guys. Three stud left wingers. Look at these. Now they want to give me Pronger as well. 94 overall. Are they crazy or something? They all want me. And they want Tanguy and Lehtonen in exchange. Now, this is the one thing that doesn't make sense, though. I can't just get rid of my players like that. No, all right. They don't want to. I am not going to accept a trade stupid like that. Montreal, for some reason, has Zdeno Chara on their team. Defenseman for... Okay, so two prospects. But it's the defenseman for left winger. And no, I'm not accepting that. I am not going to accept that. Especially since my my prospect seems to be better. So, no, I'm not accepting these shits, guys. Not going to go crazy on that. Okay, seems like two prospects. Plus, so mine is better, though, than his. So, better prospect from my perspective. Nope, I would lose this. See, I need to look at this that way. Where I would actually lose the trades. I went for it for a Steve Schott because, I mean, why not, right? They want to give it to me. But I'm not going to go crazy every time, though. Alright, so. Let's see right here. Up until we got to get to the actual season. Because I do want to simulate a little bit of the season in here, guys. So, the Ilya Bryzgalov and all of this. Alright. A lot of trades happen here. Okay, so are we good? There we go. All right. I think we're good. So finally, we can go to roster moves. Look at what we've got. So center. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Hold on. Centers. Let's see what we got. All right. So we've got Forsberg, Stahl, Fedorov, and Brian Little. Furchy so far would be our backup. Left winger, 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Perfect. Kozlov. Seems like he should probably be our actual backup guy. So we're going to have to bring down Fritsch. Fritsch is going to have to play in the minors. Right wing. Now 1, 2, 3, 4. So Clutterbuck or Bradley. We want to play one of them. We're going to play Bradley just because he's a one-way deal. Can he? Yeah, he's a one-way deal. Even if I have eventually to get him back in the minors, I'm fine with that. He's gonna go to waivers or something. I'm fine with that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's fine with that. We do need a defenseman that's gonna be there to help them out. He's 33 years of age, so I'm fine with that. Celador, you're gonna be the backup. Lehtonen with Jacques Plante. Hopefully Jacques Plante has a better year for the playoff wise, because I know we're gonna make it to the playoffs. All right. We're good. So the only one, the only guy we gotta get back to the minors is Fritsch. So let's just get Fritsch back into the minors really quick. Best lines, I guess. So 1, 2, 3. Let me just really quick see that everything's done perfectly. So just do this like that. Kozlov, you're a left winger, sure, but you should not. Tanguy is actually a left winger, so Tanguy is going to play here. Kozlov, you should not be playing here. Where's my right winger? I need a right winger right now. There we go. There he is. So Kozlov, you're not supposed to be there. So Bradley is the one that's supposed to be there. Como, there we go. That's how it's going to work. Our right wing position is still weak, but the rest, see, we considerably upgraded the rest, guys. That's really good. It's two filthy lineups there. Defense-wise, I think we're good. Yeah, definitely. Let's just see for defense-wise. Defense-wise, we've got Salvador. All right, he is back up. So, Plount, we're good. Now, Fritchie, let me just see, make sure that there's no funny things here or any players that I need to place. No, doesn't look like it. So we can go to roster moves. And you, buddy, Fritchie, one way deal. Hopefully, you're going to go to the waivers. He did not get picked up, so that's good. That's good for us. That means we still have him. Took a chance right there, but we still have him. That's good. I want to keep my prospects as much as possible, at least. And over here, just, I guess, get the best available players. So De Vries, which is one of the players we actually drafted. If you remember, we drafted him last year. A really good player. We've got another left winger here. I'm just making sure that it is really, they're really playing their position and all. Because I don't want them to not be playing their position. Alright, so we're good. I think we're good. Defense-wise, it should be all good. And goaltenders, we got these two. Alright, everything's good. It seems alright. Got everyone playing their position. So I think we can go at least start the first season up. And or actually, you know what? No, I'm just going to end it right here. Before we start the first season, we're going to actually start the second season in the next episode. Grossman, let's see if I want him or not. Actually, he's a prospect. B potential, actually pretty good. He would be a pretty good asset to us. So, yeah, let's get him in there. Grossman, nice. And with that said, so we got Grossman, so that means we can actually go to edit lines, not the right one, AHL, and we can actually put him, Smogoli. I do want to play him because he's got one hell of a potential, not so much for Petyat, so let me just see where he is, the defenseman we just picked up, Grossman. Here we are, Petyat is gonna just sit, so wait his turn. So Grossman, here you go. You just go over there and then you go. Which one is the worst? You are 26 years of age. You are a prospect. So there we go. So these are going to be the lineups now. We got a good prospect in Grossman, which is really good for us. We're going to help us out. Now that this is done, that we've got Grossman and everything, I'm actually going to end the video right here. And I'll see you guys for the next one. Remember to leave a like and subscribe if you didn't enjoy the video. Keep it easy.